I played classical guitarists for like 15, 16 years, and so like to feel these frets that I'm so used to on lutes and things on like a guitar, it just feels strange. Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. I am back today at Marshall Bernays' showroom here at his fantastic shop. Marshall, how are you doing?
Great, yourself?
Good. We are both pretty excited today because we are doing a very nerdy experiment.
Oh yeah. When you brought the idea up, I couldn't resist, and upon execution, I personally couldn't stop laughing because it just it hurt my head and tickled my senses all at the same time.
So the thing that's really getting us excited is that we are going to put gut frets on a classical guitar.
Yeah, modern Spanish style classical guitar.
Definitely blasphemy, but hey, what are nerds for? This is great.
Oh yeah, this is a lot of fun.
Now, if you don't already know, here's a quick little history lesson. All guitars today are fitted with metal frets. Frets are these pieces of metal placed periodically over the fingerboard that help us stop pitches and allow us to play chords. Now, before 1800, this was not how guitars were fretted. In fact, before 1800, they used the same material as they used for strings. So this is a Baroque guitar modeled after a 1600s Vibohm, which has gut strings, and the same material gut is now wrapped around the back of the neck here. So the frets are tied on rather than fixed. So Marshall, why do you think they used gut for the frets and for the strings?
These strings were frightfully expensive, and they still are to this day, exceptionally expensive. And so to prolong the lifespan of the strings, instead of putting metal or some wood or something else like that, they used gut because the two together wouldn't wear each other out. But ultimately it was because the cost of the gut strings for a lute was in excess of the price of the lute per year. That's why they use gut frets.
Amazing. Okay. Now, as mentioned before, today metal frets are common, but when exactly did that happen? My understanding is that guitars and lutes, basically before 1800, more or less, the guitars that I play, the Fiorbos, lutes, etc., had these nice gut frets, which have advantages, by the way, we'll get to that later. But around 1800, you have a new style of guitar being made, the birth of the six single string guitar. And gradually it started being made with metal frets. And it seems like from there on out, they just kind of stuck with metal frets, and even they switched the pegs to gradually to those like clock gear, right? Is that correct?
Yeah, as far as the frets go, they realized, hey, you know, tying on these frets is really time consuming. It's annoying. So might as well just go with this.
I love the sound of this guitar. Very mellow.
Yeah, it's mellow and punchy all at the same time.
Hmm. This is a good example of when these metal frets start becoming more ubiquitous. But today, we're not here to do what's historical. We're here to break the rules and put some gut frets on a classical guitar. So I say we should do it.
Yes, let's.
So we headed over to Marshall's shop where we found his classical guitar, which had no frets. And next we found his rather large collection of gut strings. This is, of course, sheep intestine, which historically guitarists and lutenists use for strings and frets. Then one by one, we tied on each fret onto the neck of the guitar, utilizing a standard fret knot. There are two ways of securing the knot. Normally, early plucked players just use fire. We burned the ends. But since this was a guitar that was going to a client, Marshall preferred to use a bit of glue. Then you just clip the excess gut, slide the fret down into place, et voila, we have gut frets on a classical guitar.
Are we fretted? Are we ready to go?
Yeah, we're fretted. We're ready to go.
Let's see this thing. Oh my god. Here we have it. It looks so wrong and so right at the same time, doesn't it?
It does. It does. I couldn't stop laughing at this.
I played classical guitars for like 15, 16 years, and so like to feel these frets that I'm so used to on lutes and things on like a guitar, it just feels strange.
Yes, the glissandos are going to be very interesting, to say the least.
Let's play this thing and see how it sounds.
Absolutely.
Sounds like a guitar.
Sounds very guitar-y.
So, clearly they work. I mean, if they didn't work, they wouldn't have used them for hundreds and hundreds of years, right?
Right.
I mean, it plays like a guitar, sounds like a guitar. To be honest, I could really see myself getting used to these gut frets because it's not that strange. You know, I think coming from classical guitar, maybe the first hour you're with a gut fret guitar, you're kind of freaking out because your thumb is like bumping up over all of these ridges here and it feels super strange.
Yeah, but it also has its benefits because you can probably do away with the dots because all you have to do is count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Right. It's true, you do feel these on the back of the neck, and looking at it is a different experience than metal frets. It's a less clean look, but you know, it's funny because I'm feeling this total like funny moment of knowing both worlds but having them at the same time is just is a little weird.
So it's like having ice cream on top of your steak.
That's exactly how I feel right now. Okay, so I'm already loving this whole experiment here. Have you ever put gut frets in a classical guitar before?
No, not at all. This is the first time anybody has ever said, hey, can you take gut frets and put it onto a Spanish classical guitar? We're talking about almost 60 years of actual working time.
So this is a one-time thing, unless this takes off, and then you're going to start to get a lot of requests for gut
strum. It better not. You know, the things I do for you, Brandon.
I know, man. Lots and lots of favors. So what do you think? What's your take on the result?
It's hilarious. It's fun. It definitely doesn't sound like how I expect this guitar to sound.
Interesting.
It's missing something that the metal frets typically add, which is what
Wait,
I designed
so
for.
This is actually what I wanted to ask you, because later in this video we're going to put metal frets on this guitar, because he's going to finish the instrument as it was intended. But I want to talk to you about this, because I want to make a prediction here, and see what happens here.
Okay.
My prediction was going to be that the gut frets and the metal frets were going to sound the same on the instrument, because I've played so many instruments with gut frets and they sound really good. And in my head, they're not going to sound better with metal frets. But you seem to think that this is going to sound better with metal frets. I wonder, is that true, and
yeah.
Why?
I believe it's going to, I know it's going to sound better
okay.
with metal frets, because this is designed to have metal frets. There's a response or a reflection of the note, the impulse from the string against the fret, which reflects back into the body.
Wow.
So I build guitars with a little bit more impedance or restraint than what these gut string guitars are built for.
Wow.
And because these frets are not firmly affixed, every time the impulse comes up and hits this, a little bit of extra energy is lost in the movement of the fret.
Wow. Okay, well, you're blowing my mind. I'll be very eager to get those metal frets on it and try this thing. So, our idea here now is I'm going to play a short excerpt or two, and then later, I guess in a few weeks or so, when Marshall puts the metal frets on, I'll come back and record, and we're going to compare at the end of this video and see how it sounds.
Sounds good.
Cool. Today's video is brought to you by Classical Guitar Pro. That's my brand new online classical guitar course, which is 6 hours, 53 videos. It's a whole curriculum designed to teach you what you would normally learn in the first 6 months to a year of classical guitar lessons. So if you want to learn classical guitar but are stuck, struggling reading music or struggling to learn the techniques, check out classicalguitar-pro.com to learn more. Back here a few weeks later at Marshall's shop, and now the guitar that had gut frets on it officially is completed.
Yep.
For the client who Marshall is making the guitar for in the first place, and now I am very excited to find out how this thing sounds with metal frets.
Yeah, yeah, it was a lot of fun getting it ready. It's always gratifying to see a guitar as it comes together.
Yeah, I bet. Looks beautiful.
Thank you.
And let's find out how it feels. Huh. Feels like a great guitar, Marshall.
Thank you. Smoother?
Way smoother so far. I think I played some different scales on it and some chords on it before. Let's just go ahead and test those out.
Okay.
Let's also try, I think I tried some chords. Okay. I want to test those out. Off the bat, my first thought is metal frets are always so reliable, especially when done by a great luthier like yourself. I think last time we ran into some trouble with the gut frets, and it wasn't exactly a fair comparison because the slots for the frets were already cut. And so I think the gut frets were like falling into those slots, and it was making it really hard to get a clean sound. They're kind of a little bit buzzy, which is not normally the case. So I think this experiment wasn't totally fair. I'm a big fan of gut frets. But now seeing them, you know, with metal frets, of course, it feels more reliable, and yeah. I know it's not going to buzz, so that's at least nice.
Now, what are you noticing about the sound of this guitar from the last time to now?
So I was thinking about that. I played a little excerpt from a sore piece. Let me play it as well and get a better sense of what's going on. Thing is that this thing has more sustain. It feels like it has very clean resonance. And again, with the caveat that we didn't have the perfect experiment, perfect comparison between gut frets that were really tight on as they normally would be without the slots filed. Here I'm finding that there's a kind of like a singing quality throughout any of the frets, and everything sounds good, everything sounds resonant, and it's really singing a lot more than it did with our gut experiment.
Yeah, well, I mean, it really goes to show that instruments nowadays are truly designed for these types of strings with these types of frets.
That too.
Whereas the instruments that typically have a gut fret are designed for gut fret to give the appropriate response.
Yeah.
So if you put a metal fret into a gut fret instrument, it's going to sound garish and overly wrought with sound.
Right. Well, congrats on the beautiful guitar.
Thank you.
I think my conclusion here is that for classical guitars, I'm happy to play as they did with metal frets. And for my early plucked instruments, I'm definitely not tempted to go to metal frets. I think, you know, they both had the right setup for the job.
Yep. Yeah. And as a maker, I'm happy to continue putting metal frets in. And don't anybody ask me for gut frets.
Ask them just because of this video.
You'll see the anti-promo code later.
Right. So, thank you guys for watching. I hope it was as fun to watch as it was to experiment with here in the shop. Marshall, did you want to add anything?
Yeah, for $500 off of any new guitar deposit, just type in promo code Brandon and on my website, and you'll get $500 off.
Great. Thanks again, Marshall. We'll see you guys next time.